From Fox 5 New York, this is Good Day New York.
Well, we hope you had a nice weekend. We're happy you're tuning us in this morning. Good Day New York, Monday, March 6th. I'm Rosanna Scotto.
And I'm Bianca Peters. Thanks for joining us. After a mostly clear start. Hey, look at how beautiful it looks. Well, we could see a little snow overnight. Ragged Reggie has a forecast for the week ahead.
Also starting today, the MTA is adding more trains to the Railroad. It's one of several steps ordered by Governor Hochul to reduce the overcrowding that resulted from last week's mess of schedule changes.
And an arrest has been made in the rape of a woman on the Upper West Side. The 30-year-old suspect has a long rap sheet, including a previous arrest for rape in 2019.
Also, nearly three dozen people were arrested in Atlanta after protests against a planned police training facility turned violent. They were throwing Molotov cocktails at the police officers. Police say hundreds of activists burned construction equipment, set off fireworks. It really was not good.
And in sports, the Knicks have now won 9 in a row. They defeated the Boston Celtics in a double overtime thriller. Congrats to them. We hope they stay on that hot streak.
All right, how was your weekend?
Quick and lovely. Well, you know, minus the part of getting there.
Okay.
Flight issues, as always. I can't even think about it.
Well, speaking of traveling, hello to my friends who are somewhere in the Caribbean watching us on TV right now.
Because they get Channel 5 down in the Caribbean.
Isn't that funny, Larry and Lynn? Nice to see everybody. Okay. Yeah, they're rubbing it in that they're somewhere warm, Reg and Meggie.
Yeah.
And the sun is shining and there's blue water.
Yeah, we got sun shining too. We have blue water, maybe not as crystal blue as down in the Caribbean, but I can give you a lot of sunny perspective today. How about that? Clear skies to start. We'll have sun for a good portion of the day. It will likely be slippery for your morning commute tomorrow, but then the rest of the week is sunny and windy. We have winds coming down from the northwest, so it's adding to the feel. It's a bit chillier than the thermometer's reading. It feels more like 36 in New York, 25 in Monticello, 25 also in Poughkeepsie, 31 in Belmar, and 29 in Islip. Here's your day planner. Like I said, really nice day on tap. We'll get a high of 51 degrees around 3 o'clock this afternoon. By the evening, though, we'll start seeing clouds thicken up, and there is a potential for it to start as rain and then snow overnight, and then it's out of here by daybreak tomorrow. So your morning could have about a half of an inch of sloppy mess on the roadways throughout New York City, Long Island, Lower Hudson Valley, and even into northeast New Jersey. Okay, here's a look at your seven-day forecast. Not a bad spread for the entire week, but the weekend, bring those the clocks ahead an hour, and also just in time for a coastal storm. We're eyeing that up. Too early to tell any specific details, but Saturday afternoon looks like we might be in for a storm. Okay, that's the look at your weather. Let's go to the roads and the rails with Ali Warshavsky and Frynos Gonzalez.
Good morning. It is a mess in the Bronx. Let's pinpoint a few reasons why. One big reason, Major Deegan, northbound side right by Yankee Stadium, 153rd Street. We have a crash that has shut down the northbound side. We'll let you know when that reopens. Certainly want to avoid this area. We also have a disabled tractor trailer on the upper level of the George Washington Bridge, taking out two toll lanes right now. And we have a disabled on the Cross Bronx on the northbound side right by the Bronx River Parkway. If we take you into New Jersey, new crash out there, Route 7. 17 southbound right at Route 120 Hoboken Road. We've got delays all the way to Midland Avenue there. Let's get you outside and show you what it looks like if you are trying to get over the George Washington Bridge. Right now, the upper level, 20 to 25 minutes, could slow down even more with that disabled tractor trailer. Inbound lower, you're looking at about the same. Rosanna, Bianca, over to you.
All right, thank you so much. So more changes are coming to the Long Island Railroad today.
And it comes just 1 week after the start of full-scale service to the new Grand Central Madison Terminal. Commuters complained of overcrowded trains and some rush transfers, and the MTA is responding. Fox 5's Robert Moses has more from the LARRR station in Jamaica, Queens. Robert, good morning.
Bianca and Rosanna, good morning to you. The problems of the last week led the New York Post to rechristen the LIRR the Hell-IRR. The hope is that these changes being implemented today will make the commute a bit less hellish and a bit more heavenly. And the overcrowding comes even as LIRR ridership continues to hover at a little more than 60% of pre-pandemic levels. That means that more than one-third of riders who were riding before the pandemic are not riding today. So presumably, if ridership was closer to 100%, these overcrowding issues would be even worse. Bianca and Rosanna, back to you.
Yeah, that's right. We wonder if it's ever going to get back to 100%. We'll see. Robert, thanks much. Meanwhile, a devastating fire in the Bronx, which destroyed a supermarket and laundromat, is being blamed, of course, on an e-bike battery.
You know, we keep hearing this all the time. It's just the latest in a growing number of fires caused by those lithium-ion batteries. Briella Tomasetti at the scene of the blaze in Fordham Heights. They got to make some regulations on this, Briella. We're at that point.
Yeah, Rosanna and Bianca, good morning to both of you ladies. And the city council just passed a couple of measures, I believe, last week. We'll get to that in just a little bit. And if you haven't seen the scope of the fire, how large it was, you will see all of that in just a few moments when we roll the video. But crews are still here an entire day later, pretty much monitoring the entire scene to make sure that those flames do not reignite, because it is very windy outside. The scope of the damage you don't see immediately is the jobs that were lost and the lives that were forever changed. The city council also approved a measure requiring the FDNY to educate New Yorkers about the dangers of those lithium-ion batteries we keep hearing about all over the headlines. One important thing to also keep in mind is you should never store the batteries or the e-bikes near the door, as that could be blocking a vital exit path that could save so many lives. For now, that's the very latest live here in Fordham Heights. Bianca and Rosanna, back inside to you ladies.
All right, thank you so much. One person is dead, two others in critical condition after a small plane crash on Long Island.
This happened around 3 o'clock yesterday afternoon in North Lindenhurst. According to officials, a single engine Piper took off from Republic Airport in East Farmingdale. A short time later, that pilot issued a mayday saying there was smoke in the cockpit. Turned right back to make an emergency landing, but he never made it. No one on the ground was injured, but federal officials are now investigating that crash.
Yep. Police have arrested a suspect accused of raping a 21-year-old woman on the Upper West Side. They say it happened near West End Avenue and West 65th Street early Saturday morning. Investigators say the suspect followed a woman into a building and then into the elevator. They say that's when the suspect forced her out of it and into a stairwell where he raped her. This disturbing attack has people living in the area shaken.
Honestly, I'm pretty scared, and I think I'll just try to be more careful and more cognizant of my surroundings. I think just because this is a residential area, I've never thought twice about it, but I think knowing this now, I definitely will.
Police have identified that suspect, Jamal McIver. He's 30 years old. He's from Harlem. He's charged with rape, burglary, and a criminal sex act. Officials say he has a long rap sheet, including a previous rape back in 2019.
Well, Mayor Eric Adams spoke out about questions on crime, specifically having to do with Democrat Lori Lightfoot's loss in Chicago's mayoral election.
We are focused on public safety because people want to be safe. They don't feel safe and they're actually safe, then you're going to lose control of your city.
Is what happened to her a warning sign for you here in New York?
To the contrary, I think it's a warning sign for the country. Eric Adams has been talking.
Well, Adams appeared on CNN State of the Union yesterday saying Democrats cannot ignore what the everyday public is stating on crime. He touted a double-digit decrease in shootings and homicides in New York City this year, particularly last month. His comments come after former Congressman Mondaire Jones accused him of helping to feed the Republican narrative on crime and in turn hurting Democrats ahead of 2024.
We're actually going to talk with Mayor Adams at about 7:30 this morning on Good Day New York. Don't miss it, and tweet Bianca and me what's on your mind, you know, and we'll hopefully ask him that as well.
But first, a brand new bill in Congress could lead to a complete ban on TikTok. We'll have some details on this when we come back.
For the hottest celebrity and entertainment news, join Billy Bush for Extra, weeknights at 7.
All right, when going through airport security, just about everything must go through the X-ray machine, but there's one item you should remember to remove from your bag. That would be your pets. Take your Lulu out of the pet.
I don't understand how people do this at airports, but TSA agents at Norfolk International Airport in Virginia discover this. A cat in a passenger's bag. Yeah, that was sent right through the X-ray machine.
Oh.
A spokesperson for the TSA tweeted out this picture along with a warning. Attention, pet owners, please do not send your pet through the X-ray unit. Catastrophic mistake. Now, the cat and its owner had to go through the checkpoint again the proper way. Come on. What goes through
your mind? Are you just being lazy? Come on now. Don't do that to your pet.
Was that through one of the pet carrier things?
It looked like a pet carrier, yeah.
Okay, well, yeah, they do tell you to take your animals out, so I don't know.
You know what? At least it wasn't a gun and a cat. You know what I mean, Reagan?
There we go.
We elevated that. You never know how things, crazy things happen at the airport. Just ask this one who was on like an adventure last weekend.
I'm fully aware.
All due to the weather.
Oh, yeah. I'm fully aware of airport situations. And yes, the weather has a lot to do with it. So today, clear skies for those who are flying out of LaGuardia, Newark, or JFK. Right now, it feels like 36 degrees in New York. We have those northwesterly winds coming down. Monticello, you're at 25. Look out to the west. We have a system headed this way, which will likely provide us an interesting evening and morning commute for tomorrow. Okay, that's a look at the weather. Let's go to the roads of the rails with Ali Warshavsky and Fryness Rosales.
Good morning. We got a lot going on in the Bronx this morning. One is a crash on the Bronx River Parkway at 233rd on that southbound side, adding to those morning rush delays. You can see the red on our screen. And a big one out there is the Major Deegan is closed on the northbound side at 153rd due to a crash. Also heading over the George Washington Bridge, not the smoothest ride. We have a stalled tractor trailer blocking two lanes of the upper level. So we'll take you outside and show you what it looks like if you are attempting to go over the George Washington Bridge. Can't see that stall here, but you can see a lot of people heading inbound this morning. Now we're going to toss it on over to Sky Fox, who is above the Major Deegan, and they can give us more information on what's going on there.
Well, Allie, we could share some good news and bad news. The good news is that the accident on the northbound Major Deegan Expressway that had everything closed down was cleared. However, in the delays shortly behind it, a second accident happened. That is what we see now, blocking off the center lane. This is northbound on the Deegan just before the exit for the Cross Bronx Expressway. Heavy traffic, bumper-to-bumper delays now back to the Triborough Bridge. Bianca, back to you.
Still ahead, remembering our rock and roll legend.
That's right. Good day, wake up. We'll be right back. We'll tell you who it is.
Good day, brought to you by MSC Cruises.
Ultimate tool for manipulating life.
Curing cancer by hacking the human genome?
We will see diseases cease to exist.
Tonight on the 5 o'clock news.
35 protesters have been arrested in Atlanta. This was after causing major damage in a planned police and fire training center.
It got really scary. Police say hundreds of activists breached the proposed training center where they burned construction equipment and set off fireworks towards police. There are reports that some of them threw Molotov cocktails at the police officers. The destruction occurred on the second day of what is supposed to be a week-long series of demonstrations to protest the building of the training center. Police say the demonstrators used the cover of a peaceful protest to conduct a coordinated attack on the building and them. It was not immediately clear whether anyone was injured. And this morning, we are remembering one of the founding members of a legendary rock band.
Ryan Christopher has the details on this. Ryan, good morning.
Well, good morning to the both of you ladies. So Gary Rossington, he actually helped to form the Southern rock band Lynyrd Skynyrd. And sadly, he has passed away at the age of 71. Back to you ladies.
Great music, right? All right, thank you, Ryan.
You're welcome.
When we come back, we are talking with Mayor Eric Adams.
Yes, we're going to ask him the questions that you want to know. Especially what's behind the recent drop in crime? What still needs to be done? Do you feel safer in New York City? Tweet Bianca and me. We will try to ask the mayor when we come back.
Good Day, brought to you by Raymour & Flanigan Furniture and Mattresses.
It's three new costume crusaders on DC Superheroes Night.
Riddle me this, Nick Cannon.
The Masked Singer, Wednesday at 8 on Fox 5.
Tell by my attitude that I most definitely leave from.
There's nothing you can't do. Yes, we're gathering around because it's the beginning of the week.
Oh, yeah. Look at the sunrise, too.
So pretty.
Wow.
And we're going to talk to the mayor in about 2 minutes. He's got some good news for New Yorkers who are intrepid, standing by this city through thick and thin. Thank you for watching Good Day New York. I'm Rosanna Scotto.
And then Bianca Peters is joining us. All right, speaking about that weather, we saw the sunshine up there, but that's not going to be the case later today.
No, but for a good portion of the day, Bianca, we're going to have a lot of sunshine, so fear not. And you can see just glorious, gorgeous start to your day. Okay, that's a look at your 7-day forecast. Ladies, back to you on the desk.
All right, Reagan, thanks so much. Let's talk about this now. Crime stats across the city appear to be trending in the right direction.
New numbers show a double-digit decrease in shootings and homicides in New York City last month compared to the same time last year. Joining us right now to talk about crime and more, Mayor Eric Adams. Nice to have you back on Good Day New York.
Nice to be back, and you know, I too believe New York, you know. These are great streets here in this city.
All like right, concrete Jay-Z. Dreams were, right? Concrete jungle where dreams are made of. Mayor, thank you for fighting for New Yorkers because, you know, we live in a high-taxed area, and it's terrible. We're going to lose some of our resources. Well, we appreciate you for fighting.
Thank you. Take care.
All right, you heard it from the mayor there. Let's turn things over to Allie Wachowski now. In terms of traffic, what's the commute look like, Allie?
Not looking great out there if you travel through the Bronx. We did have a crash that shut down the northbound side of the Major Deegan right by Yankee Stadium. That has been cleared, but we hear there's a crash in its place that is taking out the center lane. And we have extreme delays. See that red on our screen on that northbound side? That's going to really slow you down. Delays are stretching miles there. So if you are traveling over the George Washington Bridge, also dealing with a stalled tractor trailer on the upper level. It has been out there for quite some time, reporting that is still there, and it's taking out two lanes. So plan for a little bit of extra time if you're taking the upper level or opt for the lower instead, but we are seeing delays building there. Let's get you on over to our camera on the LIE at the Grand Central Parkway, and you can say if you're heading into Manhattan, that is the busy side onto Long Island. Busy, but not as bad. No major issues in this area of the LIE. Bianca, Rosanna, back to you.
All right, Allie, thank you. Coming up in sports, the Knicks try for their ninth straight victory.
Plus, the Nets take on the Hornets. We'll have more for you in sports. Don't go away.
Join Steve Lacy and Natasha Verma for the 5 o'clock and the 10 o'clock news on Fox 5.
Welcome back to Good Day. We have a look at some of your top stories right now. Police have arrested a suspect identified as Jamal McIver of Harlem. He's 30 years old. He is accused of raping a 21-year-old woman on the Upper West Side. It happened near West End Avenue and West 65th Street early Saturday morning. Investigators say the suspect followed the woman into the building and into the elevator. Police say the suspect then forced her out of the elevator into a stairwell where he raped her. Mr. McIver is charged with rape, burglary, and a criminal sex act. Officials say he has a long rap sheet, including a previous rape arrest back in 2019.
One person dead, two others in critical condition. This is after a small plane crash on Long Island. It happened around 3 o'clock yesterday afternoon in North Lindenhurst. Now, according to officials, a single-engine Piper took off from Republic Airport in East Farmingdale. Short time later, that pilot issued a mayday, saying there was smoke in the cockpit, and turned right back around to make an emergency landing. However, he did not make it. No one on the ground, thankfully, was injured.
More changes today to the Long Island Railroad after commuters complained of overcrowded trains and rush transfers. The LIRR is lengthening 17 trains serving Penn Station, adding cars to all trains that exceeded capacity last week. It is also increasing rush hour service between Jamaica and Atlantic Terminal in Brooklyn. And that means trains during the rush hours every 8 to 9 minutes versus around every 12 minutes. And 30 more MTA employees have been deployed to Jamaica, 10 more to Grand Central Madison to help you.
Now, after being excluded again, this is from marching under their own banner in the St. Patrick's Day Parade, the Staten Island LGBTQ plus community turned to an event of their own.
Christine Russo has the details on the controversy. All right, let's talk a little sports, shall we?
That's right. Here's Good Day Wake Up Maker Dan Bowens with more. Dan, starting off on the hardwood.
That's right. Good morning, Bianca and Rosette. A lot of people were saying this was the most important regular season weekend for the New York Knicks in 20 and 30 years. Well, guess what? They delivered. The Knicks went into Boston riding an 8-game winning streak, and it would be a long night as they tried for a 9th straight victory, but they came through. There
I
you
just
go.
Started it. It's really
I knew it. It's so good.
For Stephen with that big old target on his back. So
there is.
Yeah, great season ahead. Thanks, Dan.
You got it.
Ryan Christopher are coming up with some entertainment news.
And at 9 o'clock, you know who's going to guest host the entire 9 o'clock hour?
Love her.
Real Housewife of New Jersey, Melissa Gorga. She will be my guest co-host. Now, if you have somewhere to go, you know, I think you should cancel your plans. But if you have somewhere to go, just stream the interview. Did you know the Fox 5 NY News app is absolutely free?
Free, so you can get all the juicy details and gossip going on in Real Housewives world, right?
Never miss a moment. And if you got nowhere to go, perfect. Bianca and I will be right back.
This summer, it's the U.S. versus the world. The FIFA Women's World Cup on Fox.
Sherry Shepherd is spreading love, joy, and laughter. Catch Sherry weekdays at 10 a.m.
Good morning, Monday morning, March 6th. Here is a look at our gorgeous city. We have clear skies, so starting a lot of sunshine ahead. Feels like 36 degrees. We have these northwesterly winds coming down, knocking it down a couple of degrees, real feel. So 25 in Monticello, 25 in Poughkeepsie, 29 in Iceland. You can see 13-mile-an-hour wind sustained out of the northwest in Monticello, 6 here in New York. And then, of course, we're looking to our west, and we see this system headed this way. What it's going to do for us is basically clouds will gather by the end of the day. We could see some rain places like New York City, Long Island, Lower Hudson Valley, Northeast New Jersey, transitioning over to snow. Early morning commute, we likely could be a little slippery, about a half of an inch of accumulation gets out of here by daybreak, and then we're good to go. So what happens today is going to kind of be a repeat for tomorrow, with the exception of the overnight slipperiness for that evening commute. Let's take a look at the 7-day forecast. 51 is your high today, 45 tomorrow, and it's going to be a really nice week ahead. Saturday into Sunday, we're looking at a coastal storm and also spring your clocks forward an hour. That's a look at your weather. Let's go to the roads and the rails with Allie Warshawski.
Get that extra coffee ready. All right, we do have a jackknife tractor trailer on the New Jersey Turnpike, outer roadway northbound by exit 12. It is causing some heavy delays for northbound travelers. And then right by this, Route 1 and 9 northbound at Wood Avenue, we also have a crash that is causing some rubbernecking delays on the southbound side as well. You can take a look at the Bronx, an earlier crash on the Major Deegan on that northbound side. We still have those heavy delays because of it past Yankee Stadium. And then we do still have a disabled tractor trailer blocking two lanes of the upper level of the George Washington Bridge. Let's get you outside and show you what it looks like if you are traveling via the Holland Tunnel. Still pretty long ride from Route 1 and 9. You're looking at 35 to 40 minutes, 25 minutes from the tolls. Bianca, Rosanna, back to you.
All right. Thank you so much, Allie. Let's talk a little entertainment.
Right. Christopher, what are we chatting about this morning?
Well, we're talking about Michael B. Jordan with his shirt off. It seems like people can't get enough of that. Yeah, Creed 3 knocked out the competition at the box office this weekend. But now to some royal drama. Britain's King Charles III is apparently trying to bring the whole family back together again. Can he actually? We'll have to wait and find out for that. But the Sunday Times is reporting that Prince Harry and Meghan Markle, they've been invited to his coronation. It's official, but it's unclear if the Duke and Duchess of Sussex will actually accept the invite. Now, Charles, he will be formally crowned on May 6th in London, nearly 9 months after the death of his mother, Queen Elizabeth. Now, May 6th is also the 4th birthday of Harry and Meghan's son, Archie. Now, the Duke and Duchess of Sussex, they removed themselves, of course, from their royal duties more than 3 years ago. Since then, they've been living in L.A. with some strain, to say the least, on the family with all the TV interviews and Prince Harry's memoir, Spare. And we want to hear from you watching right now. Should Harry and Meghan attend the coronation? Our Insta poll is live right now on our homepage, and so far, most of you say you don't care. 64% of you don't care whether they're going to actually go to the coronation or not. Ladies, I'm sure you have an opinion as well. Feel free to vote now or later this morning.
I want them to go.
Oh, you do?
Come on.
Okay, yeah. Yeah, get the family back together.
She wants them to go, so there's going to be some drama so we can talk about it
more. Okay. It's the story that keeps on giving.
I'm still like trying to get us a ticket to go.
That's what I'm so we maybe we should just show up.
Yeah,
just show up.
Just show up.
Yeah, why not?
We'll take their place.
Yeah, why not, right?
Happily.
You got nothing going on.
Thanks, Ryan.
You're
appreciate
welcome.
It. All right, coming up in our next hour, New York City's Health Commissioner, Dr. Ashwin Vasan. He's going to be here.
So the city is rolling out a series of new mental health initiatives. He's going to tell us all about it coming up in just a few minutes.
Wednesday, four small town farmers welcome big city women.
I'm moving in.
For a chance at love in the heartland.
So what are you looking for?
I'm looking for you.
If Yellowstone and The Bachelor had a baby, it would be this reality show unlike any other.
Can I get a minute?
I should just quit now. Country
roads, take me home. I would really love it if you would join me in this journey.
Farmer Wants a Wife, series premiere Wednesday at 9 on Fox 5.